like this. There's a reason that we don't ride with our leg out here like this. Remember, if you watch a lot of cowboy movies, you'll see them like this, kind of. You know, I mean, I'm being over exactly. Well, here's what happens. Now your horse has no wall there. It's like if I open this rein here, look what happens. He's like, oh, look, I can go that way. So all this is just think of this as a, if we said that an 8-foot tall concrete wall they couldn't run through, this is a piece of string your leg is. That's all it is. So when you have that piece of string there, you've got to be able to say, okay, what's he going to do? Is he going to, look, see how it pushes into the pressure right there? So watch. I'm going to say, see? He'll get, So then I'll go here, right? So then if he really gets rude, I go here even more. All right? You want to try to get that horse to where you can just sit here and you can just go, I want to go there. Oh, I want to go there now. And you can go, I want to go there. Now I'll show you another thing I showed Debbie.
And you're using that outside leg to scream.
Oh yeah. So I'll show you something I showed Debbie here. So I'm gonna take this horse and I'm gonna be an offset rider here. You'll see this. So we've seen this before, but people don't know what it is. So what I'm doing is I'm going straight. I'm saying I want my horse to go straight. And I'm sitting so far off to the right, jamming my right butt throat down in. So when I'm doing that, I'm asking my horse to go straight. Because when you learn the difference between forward and stationary, and I mean that in the sense of 4 feet of the horse traveling, not in, we're stationary right now. This is a halt or stop, whatever you choose to call it. But whenever you learn about forwardness and bending and roundness, and how you can get that, and where you can put any foot, so you can go, I want 1 foot. Well, whenever you get to the point to where, like this horse, if I rode this horse for a month and I put 45 rides on him in a month because I ride him twice a day, I could sit here and bang, bang, bang like that, lift my rein a little. You're a goalie. You're blocking your horse from going left or right. That's where your legs come in. Okay. Second thing is that you're not allowed, your block comes in leg to leg and going forward. These are your other blockers here. Okay. So what we want to do is we've got to let him know he gets relief when he does the proper thing. We know that. Okay. That's kind of the basis. Here's what we do. Even if you've got a rope right now, I'll use it as a grip. So all I'm going to do, I'm going to hold contact. Okay, and I'm just gonna, there again, I've got bubble paper in between my calf and my fender of my saddle and my horn. So I'm there, right, and all I want to do is ask him to back. So then when he backs, I go left, right, left, right, left, right.
And you're actually using your calves.
I'm just holding them there. That's all I'm doing. I'm just talking. I'm a goalie. I'm blocking him from going to my left or to my right. But I want to think of it like this. See my pinkies? So watch. Whenever I go back and hold, now watch. Left pinky, right pinky, left pinky, right pinky. Because he has to get relief Remember what I said? Mm-hmm. I want to control every foot. So that's how I start controlling the feet. Is I start communicating with the idea of, okay, I'm going to eat back. And it can be that soft and easy. Most of the time, those people just seem to get that old horse to run back. You don't have to do that. If you're having that much problem, put a rope halter underneath your bridle. Associate the rope halter with the reins. So you have your lead rope on, goes up and around the neck. You have a bridle on. You apply nose pressure with your rope halter. Then you go to a rein. Then you go to nose pressure. Until finally you go to rein, he doesn't do it, bang, he hits the nose. You hit. So then all of a sudden you're weaning him off. Okay, so, next thing. So we've kind of discussed that and have that on the video. Now the next thing is going into, we've worked with Dave in reference to just staying. So what we want to think of is like this. So just look at my position, how I am. If I get to here, like this, and I turn my feet in, I have nothing. If my horse decides to go this way, I have no way of staying on it. See my feet here? Mm-hmm. Now, look, I'm around my horse. Now, if he goes to wad up or jump around, look, I got myself. I'm here. All right, okay. Where are you going to go? You're not going to go back to relaxing. But if I turn my feet straight, like this, okay? I have no, it's a matter of time. I'm going to come on. It's a matter of time. So get around him a little bit like this. Get around. But know that if you're cantering or trotting or anything, that you can move your horse. But stride or two, whatever it is. And you want to get it that subtle. You want people to be watching you and they're looking at you right there.
Down on your
knees. See right there? Put an egg right there, and that's how I roll. And they would say, okay, we're going to do our up, up, downs. We're going to do 20 minutes of it. Like what you're doing, and all it does is it starts with, most people will lean and rock their body forward. If you just are standing there and you just take your feet out like this, now just envision how you've got to squeeze just to get yourself up just a little bit. Just a little bit. And all we're doing here, because we'll get to this point, and when we get to this point, we have no squeeze here. We're out of the saddle, no contact. But when we're here, now I'm getting around my horse. Now I'm in my horse. That's all. That's the only thing that this is about. Okay? Makes sense.
That's interesting. I could see where that's going to hurt after a while.
Okay, so then we'll talk a little bit about, I'm going to come around, moving forward.